There was a village named Maniganj. The village chief was a very strict man. He wouldn't spare dishonest behavior. There was a utensil seller in the village named Radhishyam.
Dad, mom had asked for a pot to hit on her head.
No, not my head, but his head, Dad.
I gave you a pot just the other day. You need one more? Well, take this one.
Radhishyam had two children, Bablu and Chinky. Since the shop was right next door to their house, they turned up at the shop all the time.
Dad, mom has asked for a set of tongs to beat up Bablu.
No, Dad, but it is to squeeze Chinky's nose.
I think your mother will empty the entire shop. You took a pot yesterday. Today you want tongs. If you're going to use everything at home, what will I sell to my customers? Here, take the tong.
And Dad, mom has also asked you to bring 1 kilo jalebis when you come home. If you don't bring the jalebis, remember that mom has new tongs.
Are you going or not? You're just becoming like your mother day by day.
Radhishyam's shop was always busy. He was leading a happy life with his wife and his kids. However, Bhagwan Das had an eye on his happy life. Bhagwan Das and his family were new to this village. He was thinking about starting a new business.
There are at least 4 to 5 sweet shops in this village. There are quite a few convenience stores too. But there is only one utensil shop. I think I should open a utensil shop.
Bhagwan Das opened his utensil stores, but he had no customers. Everyone still went to Radhishyam's shop.
Dhanteras is approaching soon, and I haven't sold even one utensil yet. I have to do something about Radhishyam's business first. I'll make such a sinister plan that he will want to leave the village.
Late at night, when Radhishyam was shutting his shop, Bhagwan Das approached him wearing a disguise.
Hey Sonu, Radhishyam lives in my neighboring village. I have heard a lot about your shop. My daughter is getting married. I need a lot of big brass pots. Why not show?
Bhagwan Das bought the pots from Radhishyam and he took them home. He created cheap and bad quality replicas of Radhishyam's pots with steel and he polished them to make it look like brass. 2 days later, he took the vessels back to Radhishyam's shop.
Hey Sonu, my in-laws did not like the vessels. I am sorry. I would like to return these and please give me my money back. You know very well how expensive a daughter's wedding can be.
Radhishyam took the vessels back and he returned customers' money. He did not realize that he was in possession of fake vessels. By the time Dhanteras came, all of Radhishyam's brass vessels got sold. Some days later, the fake polish had faded.
This is steel. That Radhishyam has cheated us.
The villagers complained about Radhishyam to the village chief.
Radhishyam, you know the rules of this village. If in case a shopkeeper tries to cheat with the customers, then he has to leave the village. Now you cannot live in this village. You will have to pay 50,000 rupees as fine.
Radhishyam somehow managed to sell his remaining vessels and his house to pay off the fine. He took his family and left the village.
Dad, where will we go now?
I don't know, love. I don't even know a relative who lives nearby. What have you carried in this bag?
Some rice and a pot that I saved for us so that we can eat food on the way somewhere. Radhishyam's family walked all day. When the sun started to set, they rested under a tree.
Kids, we have to stay positive even during the tough times. Difficulties are also part of life. Consider this a small vacation until we can find a good shelter somewhere.
Radhishyam's wife begins to cook rice. An old man approaches them.
My son, my wife and I are hungry since 5 days. Please give me some rice from your pot or else my wife will die.
Baba, we have nothing to give you.
I think this old man is hungrier than us. We should give him some of our share.
But what will our kids eat?
I'll go to the jungle tomorrow and find something to eat. Trust the Lord. The man needs the rice more than we do, and it is our duty to help those in need.
Radhishyam gives the old man both the rice and the pot. That night, Radhishyam's family went to sleep hungry. As soon as they woke up in the morning, Bablu and Chinky started to cry.
We are very hungry. Is there anything to eat?
Radhishyam goes to the jungle to find something to eat. He encounters the same old man from the previous night.
Last night itself, a 20-year-old lost son came back to us. You helped us yesterday, and in return, I would like to give you this pressure cooker as a gift.
Before Radhishyam could say anything, the old man vanished.
Where did this old man go giving me this cooker? What am I going to do with this empty cooker? Rather, he should have given me some actual food.
In the jungle, Radhishyam came across some lotus flowers in a pond. He picks some lotus stems and takes it back to the family.
I couldn't find anything other than these lotus stems.
And where did you find this cooker?
The old man who came last night to us, he gave me this cooker. Boil the lotus stems in the cooker, then we can eat.
After some whistles of the cooker that went off, when Radhishyam's wife opened the cooker, she was shocked to see that the lotus stems had turned to gold.
How is that possible?
Radhishyam tried to boil other things in the cooker. Whatever he put in there turned to gold. Radhishyam's family goes to a neighboring village and settles down there. With the help of the magical cooker, Radhishyam opens his own jewelry store. In Maniganj, the story of the magical cooker spread around. Radhishyam was our neighbor, right? I've heard he's very successful now, but he still helps those in need. Bhagwan Das finds out about Radhishyam. The next day, he goes to his jewelry shop.
I have heard a lot about you. My wife is very ill. If she doesn't get a treatment, she will die. I am taking her to the city for the medical treatment. Please give me your gold-giving cooker just for one day. Once the treatment is done, I will bring it back to you.
Radhishyam trusts Bhagwan Das and gives him the cooker. Bhagwan Das runs back to the village with the cooker in hand.
Radhishyam is so stupid. I tricked him so easily and took his cooker. Now I will boil some potatoes in it. Potatoes will turn into gold.
Bhagwan Das puts potatoes in the cooker and puts it on the stove and waits for the stove to go off.
Come on, whistle, come on.
The cooker's whistle doesn't go off, but instead it blasts. Bhagwan Das turns black because of the blast and he starts crying.
Oh, what happened?
The saying is true. Whoever has ill intentions will get a black face.